वेलकम टू इंडिया लेक्चर्स केमिस्ट्री। मैं पुनीत दुबे आप सभी का स्वागत करता हूं। काफी दिनों बाद ये वीडियो बना रहा हूं, अभी तक बहुत बिजी हो गया था स्कूल के कामों में। सो आज का वीडियो हमारा होगा स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ एटम में। हमने पिछले क्लास में जहां तक पढ़ा था उसके आगे आज के टॉपिक में हमारा होगा एटॉमिक स्पेक्ट्रा। तो आज हम सारे एटॉमिक स्पेक्ट्रा के बारे में देखेंगे। इमिशन स्पेक्ट्रा क्या होता है, एब्जॉर्प्शन स्पेक्ट्रा क्या होता है, कंटिन्यूअस स्पेक्ट्रम क्या होता है, लाइन स्पेक्ट्रम क्या होता है, बैंड स्पेक्ट्रम क्या होता है, इन सब के बारे में हम जानेंगे। डिफरेंट एनर्जी लेवल्स के बारे में जानेंगे, डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ लाइंस, कितने लाइन इमिशन होता है, वो सब आज हम सब पोस्टमार्टम करने वाले हैं। तो अगर आप चैनल पर नए हो तो प्लीज चैनल को सब्सक्राइब कर लें ताकि हर वीडियो का नोटिफिकेशन आप तक सबसे पहले पहुंच सके, और अधिक से अधिक लोगों को शेयर करें ताकि इसका बेनिफिट और सभी के साथ शेयर हो सके। चलिए आइए शुरू करते हैं एटॉमिक स्पेक्ट्रा। सो what we can say that atomic spectra, it is observed that when a ray of light is passed through a prism, jab koi light prism ke through pass karte hai to kya hota hai, wo ek band mein break down ho jata hai, aur wo uska jo arrangement hota hai wo according to their wavelength or according to their frequency hota hai. So wave number, it is and the wave with shorter wavelength bend more than that of the one without the bigger wavelength. तो शॉर्टर वेवलेंथ जो होता है उसका जो बेंडिंग होती है वो सबसे ज्यादा होता है। तो हम कह सकते हैं वेवलेंथ इज इनवर्सली प्रोपोर्शनल टू द बेंडिंग, मीन द लाइट इज हैविंग शॉर्टर वेवलेंथ विल बेंड मोर, राइट। फॉर एग्जांपल इफ आई एम लाइट इज पासिंग हियर एंड हियर द सीरीज ऑफ लाइन इज कमिंग विच इज वी आर सेइंग हियर विव ग्योर, राइट। विव ग्योर वेरी फेमसली वी नो दैट विव ग्योर मीन्स दिस लाइट इज बेंडिंग फ्रॉम हियर टू देयर एंड हियर टू देयर. So this bending from original path, this is the maximum bending. So we can say that violet is having lower wavelength and its bending will be maximum in this way. So since ordinary light consists of wave with a wavelength of in the visible range, we know that the light is coming from sun or the white light is coming from the any of the source which is having a different colors of light. And that is making a white light, and which having different colors of light, that means it is having the different wavelength and different frequencies. So a ray of white light is spread out into the series of colored lights or bands is known as the spectrum. So what is this wavier is here, that wavier is the pattern where the light of different wavelength is going to be arranged in a manner from increasing order of the wavelength or decreasing order of the wavelength. Or in another way, you can say that in increasing order of frequency or decreasing order of frequency, that pattern is known as the spectrum. Is that clear? So now next statement is the light of red color, which has the longest wavelength, is deviated least, while the violet light, which is here downside, violet light, which has the shortest wavelength, is deviated most. This is all dependent on the wavelength and inversely proportional to its bending. Is that clear? Now spectrum, we have two type of spectrum is here. Very first, it is the emission spectrum, another is the absorption spectrum. Two type of spectrum is there, and further these two can be divided into the emission spectrum can divided into the continuous spectrum, line spectrum and band spectrum. Is that clear? And absorption spectrum further can be divided into the line spectrum and band spectrum. So these all are we are going to study about the what is the continuous spectrum, what is the line spectrum, what is the band spectrum, what is the emission spectrum, what is the absorption spectrum. One by one we will see all. So the arrangement obtained by various types of electromagnetic waves in order of their increasing frequency or decreasing wavelength is called the electromagnetic spectrum, right. So ye hamara electromagnetic spectrum ka pattern hota hai. तो यहाँ पे हम क्या देखें, पहला हम देखेंगे इमिशन स्पेक्ट्रम. सो हियर व्हेन द रेडिएशन इज इमिटेड, व्हेन द रेडिएशन इज इमिटेड फ्रॉम द इनकैंडेसेंस सोर्स, फॉर एग्जांपल दैट इज अ पास थ्रू अ डायरेक्टली थ्रू द प्रिज्म एंड द पैटर्न ऑब्टेन्ड ऑन द स्क्रीन इज कॉल्ड द इमिशन स्पेक्ट्रम, राइट, इज कॉल्ड द इमिशन स्पेक्ट्रम. When the radiation, whatever the radiation is coming from the incandescent source, maybe a candle, maybe a halogen, whatever it is containing the mixture of light, when you are going to pass through a prism, and what will happen here? Splitting of the light in different colors according to their wavelength or according to their frequency is going to be patterned out there, and that is known as the emission spectrum. That here, incandescent source means the candle, sun, tube light. That example is coming here, tube light, bulb, or by passing the electrical discharge through a gas at a lower pressure or by heating some substances at higher temperature. So these are the example of the incandescent source. Exam yaad rakhiyega, exam mein kabhi kabhi pooch deta hai ki incandescent source is the example of. So such example you can say there. So very first, emission continuous spectrum. What is it? Emission continuous spectrum. And when a narrow beam of light, white light, is passed through a prism, it is dispersed into the seven colors. It is dispersed into the seven colors from violet to red, which is very famously known as the Vivgior. आप बहुत पहले से पढ़ते आ रहे होंगे Vivgior, जिसको हम हिंदी में इंद्रधनुष बोलते हैं. तो ये V stands for violet, I stands for indigo, B stands for blue, G stands for green, Y stands for yellow, O stands for orange, and R stands for red. So these are making the Vivgior, which is known as the Indradhanush in Hindi, agar hum bole to. Next, the spectrum of white light ranges from violet 7.5 into 10 to the power 14 hertz to the red 4 into 10 to the power 14 hertz. तो हम यहाँ बोल सकते हैं यहाँ पे फ्रीक्वेंसी ज्यादा है वॉयलेट की एज कंपेयर टू द रेड, बिकॉज रेड इज हैविंग लोअर एनर्जी देन दैट ऑफ द वॉयलेट, वेयर एज वॉयलेट इज हैविंग शॉर्टर वेवलेंथ देन दैट ऑफ द रेड. तो यहाँ पे हम बोल सकते हैं लेमडा जो हमारा वेवलेंथ होता है और फ्रीक्वेंसी एक दूसरे के इनवर्सली प्रोपोर्शनल होते हैं. जिसका फ्रीक्वेंसी ज्यादा होगा वेवलेंथ कम होगा, वेवलेंथ ज्यादा होगा फ्रीक्वेंसी कम होगी. तो इस तरीके से हम यहाँ भी एक पैटर्न बना सकते हैं. नेक्स्ट, this is a white light is coming and it is going to through the passing through the prism. And what is happening here? Passing through the prism and it is going to split up into the spectrum, which is known as the here Vivgior. So here violet, blue, violet, indigo, blue, green, orange, yellow, orange and red. So these are the pattern of Vivgior, but I'm telling to you this is about the continuous spectrum. So there all the lines or the colors of the light which is present in this spectrum, these are in the continuous manner. That's why it is known as the continuous spectrum. There is no line or there is no band in between the color separation. So that is known as the continuous spectrum. If there will be, then it will be known as the line spectrum or band spectrum. Right now, second is the emission line spectrum. What is it? Now come to the statement. When an atomic gas is subjected to the electrical excitation or high heat of source, then it first absorbs the energy and then it gives it out as a radiation. क्या बोल रहे हैं यहाँ पे? Simply for example, if I am saying sodium atom is going to be electrical excitation, it is going from ground state to the excited state. Ground state to the excited state. Then in this condition, what will be happen here? It will absorb the radiation. And when this source is going to be removed, whatever the heat you are giving here or you are giving the electrical discharge, then after what will happen here? This radiation, whatever this atom has been absorbed, now this radiation is coming out from that atom. That radiation, on examining this radiation through the spectroscopy, this is another instrument which is using for the study of the spectrum, radiation through the spectroscope, a spectrum is obtained which have the well-defined lines, which have well-defined lines. Here, line is absent, line nahi hai, aur koi bhi band nahi hai. That's why it is known as the continuous spectrum, whereas well-defined line is present in the line spectrum and each correspond to a definite wavelength. And each lines are separated from each other by a dark space. Each line is separated by a dark space, point to be noted here. This type of emission spectrum is called the emission line spectrum. तो ये exam में पूछा जाता है, board examinations में पूछे जाते हैं, NEET JEE mains में पूछे जाते हैं, what is the line spectrum? So here mainly what you have to remember, atomic gases is going to be subjected electrical discharge or giving the heat source. That's why it is absorbing the radiation, and after removing this source, this is going to be again emit the radiation, and that radiation is going to examine by the spectroscope, and they are very well known line is going to be present there. That's why it is known as the line spectrum. So here comparable example I have put here. So this is known as the continuous spectrum, and there is no line in between the colors of the different wavelengths which is having. But here it is having a red color, blue color, violet color, pink color, whatever color you can mention there. So this line, these colors of wavelength, this is particular wavelength 1, wavelength 2, wavelength 3, and these wavelengths are separated by a dark spaces. That's why it is known as the emission line spectrum. Is that clear, everyone? Now, third term is the emission band spectrum. And what is it? If the molecular form of gases, there was atomic form of gases, and here it is, molecular form of gases is used, and it first absorbs the energy for not only the electronic transition, but for the rotational, vibrational, and electron translational motion, then it remits the radiation. For example, CO2, any other molecule, you can say that it is going to be first, it is going to be absorbed the radiation, and it will go to the excited state. And then when the source of radiation which is absorbing either in the form of heat or in the form of electrical discharge, after removing that, now in excited state, it is again radiate that emission radiation. It will be here, it is going to be radiated, and this radiation is again going to be examined with the spectroscope. And what you are getting here on examining this radiation through the spectroscope, a spectrum is obtained which contains group of closely packed lines, called it as a band. Now, therefore, this type of emission spectrum is known as the emission band spectrum. Emission band spectrum, here you can observe, this is for hydrogen and helium, right? So these are each bands, these are the bands now, and these bands are again separated by the dark spaces. Are you getting my point? These are separated by the dark spaces. Is that clear? So this is known as the band spectrum. Now the time for the absorption spectrum. और अगर कोई भी डाउट होता है इनसे जिस लेके, तो आप हमको कमेंट बॉक्स में अपने डाउट्स को क्लियर करने के लिए क्वेश्चन पूछ सकते हैं, हम उसको क्लियर कर देंगे। और मैं सजेस्ट करूंगा कि इस वीडियो तक पहुंचने से पहले आप पुराने वीडियोस देखें, ताकि आपको समझ में आए कि हमें एटॉमिक स्पेक्ट्रम की रिक्वायरमेंट क्यों है और क्यों हम इसके बारे में स्टडी कर रहे हैं। आइए स्टडी करते हैं अबाउट एब्जॉर्प्शन स्पेक्ट्रम। व्हाट इज इट? दैट वाज द इमिशन स्पेक्ट्रम एंड दिस इज द एब्जॉर्प्शन स्पेक्ट्रम। नाउ व्हेन व्हाइट लाइट इज फर्स्ट पास्ड through a solution or in the vapor form of a chemical substance or a gas, then it is analyzed by the spectroscope. There, what is happening there? Just it is giving the radiation and it is coming out the emission in the form of emission. That radiation that is going to be observed in the spectroscope, that is known as the emission spectrum. Now here, very first excited sample is going to be whatever the white source of light is here, that is coming and it is passed through an absorbing sample. And that sample may be in the solution form or in the vapor form of the gaseous substances or any chemical substances. And then after it is passing through a prism and it is going to be detected after that. It is observed that some dark lines are obtained in otherwise the continuous spectrum. यहाँ पे कोई भी continuous spectrum आपको देखने को नहीं मिलेगा। किसमें? Absorption spectrum में। Absorption spectrum में continuous spectrum नहीं मिलता है देखने को। और यहाँ पे क्या मिलता है आपको? कुछ डार्क बैंड्स मिलती हैं, डार्क स्पेसेस मिलते हैं, एंड सम लाइंस इज गोइंग टू बी ऑब्टेन्ड देयर। सो दिस टाइप ऑफ स्पेक्ट्रम इज कॉल्ड एब्जॉर्प्शन स्पेक्ट्रम, बिकॉज दिस स्पेक्ट्रम इज फर्स्ट, दिस रेडिएशन इज फर्स्ट एब्जॉर्ब बाय द केमिकल सब्सटेंस और एनी गैसेज, एंड देन आफ्टर इट इज गोइंग टू बी ऑब्जॉर्ब इन द स्पेक्ट्रोस्कोप, राइट? नेक्स्ट पॉइंट, इफ द व्हाइट लाइट इज पास थ्रू द एटॉमिक गैसेज, देन the obtained spectrum is called absorption line spectrum, in the same as line and band spectrum in forming. When it is passed through atomic gases, then it will give you the line spectrum, and when it is passed through molecular gases, then it will give you the band spectrum. It is same as whatever you have studied in the emission spectrum, right? Next, line spectrum of hydrogen. Line spectrum of hydrogen, when an electrical excitation is applied on the hydrogen, atomic gases at the lower pressure and bluish light is emitted. Hydrogen yahan pe jab excitation kara jata hai uska, then after at lower pressure, and wo kya karta hai, aapko blue light emit karta hai. And when this ray of light is passed through a prism, a spectrum of several isolated sharp lines is obtained. A spectrum of several sharp light is going to be obtained. आप यहाँ पे देख सकते हैं हाइड्रोजन में आपको यहाँ पे ब्लू लाइंस देखने को मिल रही हैं। Is that clear? Now the wavelength of various lines shows that the spectrum lines in the visible ultraviolet and in the infrared region. So यहाँ पे जो हमारा वेवलेंथ मिलता है वो मैच करता है किसके साथ, विजिबल रेंज के साथ, अल्ट्रावायलेट रेंज के साथ और आईआर रेंज के साथ, राइट? सो दीज लाइंस आर ग्रुप्ड इनटू द डिफरेंट सीरीज, और ये हाइड्रोजन के साथ जब स्टडी किया गया तो उसको डिफरेंट सीरीज के अकॉर्डिंग उसको बांट दिया गया है, और उस सीरीज को हम पढ़ने जा रहे हैं, वेरी फेमसली हम जानते हैं इसके बारे में, और ये बहुत सारे एग्जाम में पूछा भी जाता है, राइट? Now come to some statement. Very first, Balmer shows in 1885 on the basis of experimental observation that if a spectrum line is expressed in terms of wave number is what? Wave number is inversely proportional, is inverse of the lambda, inverse of the wavelength is known as the wave number. So here we can say that 1 by lambda is equal to nu bar. This is the wave number. Then the visible lines of the hydrogen spectrum obey the following formula. Which is formula? Nu bar is equal to 109677 1 upon 2 square for the visible range. This is for the visible range, second orbit, and N2 square. This is the N2 square from where the emission is coming, from where the electron is coming. That is, I'm going to tell you very soon. It is in the centimeter inverse, right? And this is the constant value which is known as the Rydberg constant. Very soon you will understand about this. So here n is an integer equal to or greater than the 3, equal to or greater than 3, because visible range light is coming from the orbit number 2 only for the hydrogen atom. So here, now this series line described by this formula is called as the Balmer series. Balmer series. And the Balmer series of lines are only the lines of hydrogen spectrum which appears in the visible range. Otherwise, all the lines is coming in the ultraviolet, IR, far IR, near IR. So these are going to be present in that. Another Swedish spectroscopist, Johns Rydberg. Johns Rydberg noted that all the series of lines in the hydrogen spectrum could be described by the following expression. This is a general formula. This is a general formula that was specific for the Balmer series. And this is for the general formula. Nu bar, you can see that 1 by lambda, this is the wave number, will be is equal to 109677 into 1 upon N1 square minus 1 upon N2 square. Bahut famous hai, yahan se bahut sare questions bante hain competitive examinations mein. Toh ye formula toh aapko टिप पे होनी चाहिए, आपके टिप पे होनी चाहिए, टंग पे. वेयर n1 इज इक्वल टू 1 2 3 4, वेयर n2 विल बी n1 प्लस 1, n1 प्लस 2, n1 प्लस 3. व्हेन n1 इट विल बी 1, देन n2 विल बी 2 3 4 5 6. इफ n1 विल बी 3, देन n2 विल बी 4 5 6 7 8, लाइक दैट. व्हाटएवर n1 विल बी फिक्स्ड, देन n2 विल बी प्लस 1 प्लस 2 प्लस 3 प्लस 4 फ्रॉम देयर. आर यू गेटिंग माय पॉइंट? वेरी गुड. Now the value of 109677 centimeter inverse is called the Rydberg constant for hydrogen atom, hydrogen molecule, right? This is the Rydberg constant for the hydrogen. So the first five series of lines that correspond to the N1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 are known as the Lyman series, Balmer series, Pasten series, Brackett, Fund, and Humphrey in the last episode 6, what it is. If it will be there, we will discuss about them. So here, very first, n is equal to 1. If I'm saying electron is coming from the infinite and it is coming to the orbit number 1 in the hydrogen, then that line of series is known as the Lyman series, and its range in the ultraviolet range. It is coming. This electron can come from the n number 2, n is equal to 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, whatever it will be there, that will come into the destination, will fix is equal to n is equal to 1. Then always it is known as the Lyman series of lines. What it will be known as? Lyman series of lines, which is present in the ultraviolet region. Is that clear? In the second case, destination, final destination will be n is equal to 2. And when n1 is equal to 2 will be fixed here, then n2 will be 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, like that. And always it is known as the Balmer series. It is always present in the visible range. This is the only Balmer series in the hydrogen spectrum which is present in the visible range, and its wavelength is varying from 4,000 angstrom to the 7,500 angstrom. Are you getting my point? Next, Pasten series. This is a near IR, and final destination n is equal to 3 will be here. So n1 is equal to is going to be 3. It is fixed. Then this type of spectrum line is known as the Paschen, and it is present in the near IR region. Next is the bracket. When n1 will be is equal to 4, it is going to be fixed here. And electron coming from any of the orbital more than this 4, maybe 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, infinite, it will be known as always bracket, and it is present in the far IR region. Is that clear? Likewise, in the Fund, n1 is going to be fixed here 5. So destination will be 5, fifth orbit of the hydrogen atom. Then whatever the electron is coming from the infinite to 6, infinite or from the 6, in between that 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 to infinite, from there it is coming to the fifth orbit. Then this type of spectrum is known as the Fund spectrum. This series of line is in the Fund series, and it is always found in the far IR region. Is that clear? In this way, we can just define how many type of line of series we are getting in the hydrogen atom, right? So this is also very important in the examination, competitive examination, it is always going to be asked. So please remember it. It's very important for the examination point of view. Now come to the next. Total number of lines. How many number of lines is you are going to be obtained when it is coming from the fifth orbit to second orbit, seventh orbit to first orbit? So it will be N1 and N2. Electronic transition takes place from any of the orbit, say N2 to N1. Say N2 to N1, this is hydrogen atom, this is the N1, and this is the N2. You don't know what is it. It may be infinite, it may be 8, it may be 10, it may be 12, whatever it will be. N1, it is also from 1 to infinite, in between that, whatever it will be, but N1 must be lesser than that of the N2. So total number of lines, how many lines you are going to get, that is very important. How many lines you will get, that is the total formula I have given here. N2 minus N1, total number of lines is equal to N2 minus N1 into N2 minus N1 plus 1 upon 2. It will give you the total number of lines. Is that clear? Total number of lines you will get when the electronic transition takes place from the N2 to N1. Is that clear? Now, for checking these two questions I have given here, please solve it and comment your answer here in the comment box. Whatever the answer you are getting here, put it in the comment box. I will tell you the right answer. So here in hydrogen, if electron moves from nth orbit to the first orbit by the transition in the multi-steps, if there is a total number of lines is 10, then what? Find out the value of n here. Very first question, answer is given. If you are getting the same, comment box is open for that answer. Next is calculate the wavelength of third line of the bracket series in the hydrogen spectrum. And the answer is still waiting. Please comment your answer in my comment box. It is already open for you, right? So thank you. This is a very small, short video, and it is a very important from the examination point of view. I hope video aapko pasand aayi hogi. Agar video aapko pasand aaya ho, तो प्लीज वीडियो को लाइक कर लें, चैनल को सब्सक्राइब कर लें और इसको अधिक से अधिक शेयर करें ताकि इसका बेनिफिट सबको मिल सके. ओके, और आपको जो भी डाउट्स होते हैं, जो भी क्वेश्चंस होते हैं, आप कमेंट बॉक्स में एनी टाइम क्वेश्चंस को पूछ सकते हैं और उसके डाउट्स को मैं क्लियर कर दूंगा. थैंक यू. हैव अ नाइस डे.